Well, good morning, everyone. Welcome to worship. To those of you joining us on Zoom this morning or connecting through Facebook, and especially to those who are connecting for the first time, I see a few of you out there, so welcome to worship. I am Cheryl Perry, for those who don't know me, and part of the worship team leading with me this morning is also Bob Wallace, Francis Chason, and Jessica Crawford. And this morning, Liz Bassisti has written and will read the prayers of the people, and along with, Tanya Pritchard. And Lindsay Meyer is reading scripture for us. Supporting us on the technical side every week is Kim Dukes, Mike Chason, and Sophia Chason. And we have some very special music this morning as well, a duet by Rhonda Draper and Carla Friesen. We invite you to participate in worship. If you are connecting through Zoom, you have the ability to do that by typing a prayer concern, a name of someone you'd like to pray for, or a concern that you have, it using the chat feature, which for me on a laptop is at the bottom of my screen. If you're using an iPad, it might be on the top, but if you haven't used it before, you might give that a whirl. And if you type it either to everybody or privately to Tanya Pritchard, those prayers will be included later in the service in the prayer of intercession. We begin our service of worship. We light a candle to remember Jesus, the one who is called Light of the World.
And we gather and remember and acknowledge with gratitude that we in the Central Okanagan area are gathered today on the ancient and unceded territory of the Sioux peoples. We commit ourselves to learn to walk with respect and appreciation into a new relationship built on trust and reconciliation. So we come to worship. We come to worship our God, who has done wonders in our lives.
God anoints us with joy and light, gifts from the treasures of God's heart.
We come to follow Jesus, who bears our lives with grace and hope.
Jesus would send us into the brokenness of the world to bring healing.
We come to be touched by the Spirit, who brings gentleness and peace for all.
The Spirit would enable us to offer reconciliation and justice to everyone we meet.
Our opening hymn comes from Voices United at number 644.
Before we start, if the words happen to be hidden by your gallery of people at some point during this service, you can minimize them briefly, because I'm sure you want to look at everyone's beautiful faces as we go through, but you can minimize them. There's a little button at the top of the gallery if you need, or you can just move the gallery to the other side of your screen. Here is, I was there to hear your mourning cry.
A faith to suit you well. In a blaze of light you wandered off to find where demons dwell. When you heard the wonder of the word, I was there to cheer you on. You were raised to praise the living Lord, to whom you now belong. If to find someone to share your time and to join your hearts as one. I'll be there to make your verses rhyme from dusk till rising sun. In the middle of the wood of your life, not too old, no longer young, I'll be there to guide you through the night, complete what I've begun. When the evening gently closes in and you shut your weary eyes, I'll be there as I have always been, with just one more surprise. I was there to hear your morning cry. I'll be there when you are old. I rejoice the day you were baptized to see your life unfold.
Though we are assured that God is with us throughout our lives, we don't always live as if we believe that is true. We don't use our gifts to our fullest. We hoard them, or we waste them, or we abuse them. Let us turn to God in prayer, asking for forgiveness.
Bob, you're muted.
Of course, we will do everything you ask, faithfulness of creation, even as we cross the fingers of our souls behind our backs. Yes, we could go where people are suffering, but we like the comfort of our homes. Yes, we could be with others as they seek to endure life, but compassion is often hard to share. Yes, we could offer hope to the hungry and homeless, but we barely have enough for ourselves. Forgive us, steadfast love, and have mercy on us. Remind us that it was when we were most foolish, you became fallible. It was when we were vile, you became so vulnerable. When the world would not welcome us, Jesus came to listen to our emptiness, to comfort our grieving hearts, to cast out death's power over us.
Take comfort in the assurance that God accepts us just as we are and guides us on our way. We are God's people, loved and forgiven. Thanks be to God.
Amen.
And now Lindsay Meyer, who's one of our graduates, is going to read scripture for us.
A reading from Matthew's Gospel. Now the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain where Jesus told them to go. When they saw him, they worshiped him, but some doubted. Jesus came near and spoke to them. I've received all authority in heaven and on earth. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to obey everything that I've commanded you. Look, I myself will be with you every day until the end of this present age. The witness of the early church.
Thanks be to God.
Hello, friends. I hope you're well. I miss seeing you. And another thing I'm really missing this year is the opportunity to celebrate with our graduates in person. A couple of weeks ago was Pentecost Sunday, where we celebrated the birthday of the church. We have been celebrating birthdays in different ways during this time. Not gathering for large parties, doing drive-by and socially distant celebrations.
This Sunday, we are recognizing some other people who've had a significant moment in their lives, graduation, happen in this time of physical distancing and school closure. So I had an opportunity to interview them and ask them about their experiences. What had it been like to graduate during a time of pandemic? What was different? Disappointing, maybe? Memorable?
Hi, my name's Greta, and I'm graduating from Kelowna Secondary School. So I think my plan is to go to UBCO, and I want to study fine arts and psychology.
Hello, my name is Colin Hilmer. I'm graduating from RSS 2020, and next year I plan to go to Okanagan College for sciences.
Hi, my name is Lindsay Meyer, and I'm graduating from Kelowna Secondary School. Next year, I will be attending UBC to study kinesiology and compete on the track and field team.
Hi, I'm Fraser Newbury, and this year I'll be graduating from Kelowna Secondary School. This fall, I'll be attending the University of Waterloo in the mechanical engineering program. Well, I'll be starting university online in the fall for at least one term and staying here in Kelowna. And I'm hoping I can go to Waterloo in January.
Hi, I'm Graham Phillips. I just graduated from Rutland Senior Secondary, and I plan to be an animator by taking the animation diploma at Okanagan College.
It's been so weird. Like, I think there's definitely been some blessings that I haven't expected to come out of this. For my school, for our grad ceremony, we just had to do time slots where 12 people were allowed in the building at a time. So I got to choose like 11 of my closest friends and go with them and kind of record the ceremony and then take photos afterwards, which I thought was really nice. The fact that I haven't been able to like walk down the hallway with my friends for the last time, or even like get my yearbook signed by people, or like there's so many little things that I didn't know it was going to be my last time doing them in high school.
Well, it was kind of hard at first because the school district wasn't really prepared to go online school. So every teacher was doing their own thing, and you kind of had to just adapt and hope your classes didn't overlap or you didn't have something else to do. And it was really hard at first, but eventually teachers kind of figured out what was going on and the classes like kind of settled out. It was definitely really hard to do finals by myself without really being able to talk to teachers a whole lot.
I think not having the last few months of your grade 12 year to spend with your friends has been really hard, like missing out on the last few big grad events, missing prom, missing dry grad, missing commencement. You can hang out with your close friends as much as you want, but it's those people that you see in class that you don't see every day, you don't hang out with outside of school, that like missing a big grad event, you're gonna miss seeing those people, and you might never see them again because you're not super close with them. You don't.
Graduating during a pandemic, it's definitely been a big change for me. I'm usually more of a social person, so not being able to see my friends or teachers or like loved ones all the time is kind of, you know, I don't really like that. Mm-hmm. But work standpoint, it's phenomenal. I've been able to get so much done. So that's a positive side to it.
I'd say the most disappointing part is missing out on baseball this year, because it's something I've played baseball in the spring for a long time and I was really looking forward to it. And I didn't really realize how much I missed it or would miss it until I haven't been playing.
It's been weird. I'm definitely gonna miss out on not having prom and the grad commencement, but at the same time, it's pretty memorable. Like, I'm never gonna forget my grad year because it's pretty unique. Just take any opportunities you can to have fun. You're not gonna remember all the times of just studying and stuff, but you're gonna remember all the stuff that you go out and join clubs and all that. Mm-hmm. I joined a robotics club this year. I wasn't even into it, but I just joined it for fun, and we got to go to Victoria, so it was definitely a good time and a lot of good memories from that. So just do anything you can to get experiences in high school because they'll stick with you for life.
Just kind of enjoy every moment because it's your last year and it goes by so fast. And take it all in because it's a really fun year.
I guess just kind of be patient because it's hard for everybody. And teachers understand that because most of my classes got significantly easier once we were online, and I think everyone's having a hard time, so just try and be patient.
I'd say just make sure you keep in contact with other people, like just find like a media platform like Skype or Zoom or Discord or something like that, just to like keep in touch. Just always check into your friends and family.
The first thing that I kind of thought of when thinking of like a memory of church was when Isabella and I would teach Sunday school for a few weeks, and I really enjoyed that. And I thought that was such a fun way to interact with all the kids in our congregation. And like, I just loved like planning the little crafts with them and kind of doing it and just talking and hearing what they have to say about different topics. Yeah, I'm thinking of possibly becoming like a grade 1-2 teacher. And so I thought like, I think maybe that probably had a part to play in it.
One thing that really stands out to me is lighting the candle. When I was really young, we did that like numerous weeks. I did it with my mom usually. We'd walk up to the front, light the candle during the song, and then walk back and sit down. Along with the Christmas pageant, I remember like standing on the steps singing the songs and everything and getting all dressed up in the like white angel costumes.
One memory I have that's good from church is at Rutland United, I think 3 or 4 years ago, I helped with there was some dinner and I was putting out food and cleaning plates, and it was just fun to interact with all the people, and everyone was really positive there and just having a good time. Everybody was nice. It was a good memory.
And you've helped out with our New Year's Day dinner at the church and the outreach program on Tuesdays and Thursdays as well.
Yeah, those are good too.
Yeah.
You all like positive experiences.
Yeah. You like to give back. You like to
try and do anything I can to help people.
I have so many memories from church.
Yeah?
Not even like they weren't even like memories from like being at the church specifically, but like I remember the trips to Naramata, like the retreat that we went on as a family, and I also remember like the camping trips that we used to go on, like at Dunlop and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Those were like the best times ever. We just sit around like a campfire or like in like a drum circle, and then we just like sing songs and stuff like that. It was really nice. But then like at church, I'd say maybe receiving my Bible. I remember that, yeah, because it was like in grade 6. I remember going up there, I was like, whoa, getting the Bible. This is a big thing, and everyone's watching. And then Remembrance Day was also a big part of that, because I like going up there and then saluting and thinking about my grandfather, great-great-grandfather. So
recently, I had someone from San Diego, one of the youth leaders in San Diego, actually call me, which was really nice. I had called with him a few times after he moved, but he said he had just been going through his phone book and decided to give me a call, and that was really nice that he was thinking about other people in this crazy time, and he decided to call me, and I was really thankful for that. We didn't talk for very long, but it was nice to know he was thinking about me. I was thinking of like the New Year's Day dinner. Mm-hmm. It's always something kind of fun to do. Mm-hmm. I have family because we all go and volunteer, and the past few years I've washed the dishes, which is not very fun, but I can do it quickly, so yeah, that's always something that's it's fun to do, but it's also helpful to the community.
We give thanks for our church and the extended family that it blesses us with, and we give thanks for these graduates in our midst. Even as you have faced challenges and accomplished much, your lives are moving into a new chapter where more will be demanded of you in order to accomplish good things. May God's grace cover your anxieties and fears so that you might stay encouraged about the future.
Before we hear a bit of music, I just wanted to tell you that the two singers, the musicians who are going to sing for you, are Carla Friesen and Rhonda Draper. And Carla is Greta, who you saw in that video, her mom, and Rhonda is her aunt.
There's more that rises in the morning than the sun, and more that shines in the night than just the moon. Shelter that is larger than this room. It's a loyalty that's deeper than mere sentiment, and a music higher than the songs that I can sing. The stuff of earth competes for the allegiance I owe only to the giver of all good things. So if I stand, let me stand on the promise you pull me through. And if I can't, let me fall on the grace that first brought me to you. And if I sing, let me sing for the joy that is born in me this song. And if I weep, let it be as a child who is longing for her home. And there's more that dances on the prairies than the wind, more that pulses in the ocean and the tide. There's a love that is deeper than the love between friends, more gentle than a mother's when her baby's at her side. And there's a loyalty that's deeper than mere sentiment, and a music higher than the songs that I can sing. The stuff of earth competes for the allegiance I owe only to the giver of all good things. So if I stand, let me stand on the promise that you will pull me through. Let me fall on the grace that first brought me to you. And if I sing, let me sing for the joy that is born in me this song. And if I weep, let it be as a child who is longing for her home. If I stand, let me stand on the promise that you will pull me through. Oh, and if I can't, let me fall on the grace that first brought me to you. And if I sing, let me sing for the joy that is born in me this song. And if I weep, let it be as a child who is longing for her home.
Well, thank you both. That was absolutely beautiful, Rhonda and Carla, and a special tribute today. Very short comments this morning. Today's gospel tells the story of the 11 disciples who are graduating, as it were. They've been with Jesus, learning and following, and now, after his death and resurrection, he's turning the ministry over to them. He gives them his authority. He gives them a task, one which seems almost impossible. And he promises to be with them, though how he is a bit unclear. So there they sit, excited, scared, sure of themselves and filled with doubts, perhaps like most of us today, and particularly our graduates. I don't want to push that analogy too far, but I want to point out one thing that I can find in this story. These disciples are standing between two worlds, between the safe world of what has been and the edge of a new world and time. In one way, we are all standing there today. The events of these past few weeks have brought both changes and challenges and the need for more radical changes. This is true for all of us. We are beginning something new, and we will find both uncertainty and excitement in the journey ahead. But today is about graduates. Like the disciples, your time with family and church has given you a firm foundation. You've learned who you are and what you believe while you've been in our presence. But soon you will go and explore the wider context of living as adults, set free to soar or tumble on your own. Like those disciples, I know you're excited, and perhaps deep down just a little unsure. That's normal. But I can tell you one thing for sure, wherever you go and whatever happens, you are surrounded by the love and support of your home and your church. Almost 30 years ago, a Canadian singer named Anne Murray wrote a song for a moment such as this. In the chorus, she wrote, "Roots and wings, gifts of love, holding me strong and lifting me up, child of the earth and rider of the wind, a dreamer of dreams caught between roots and wings." Ahead, there will be struggles. There will be joy. You will know doubts and fear. You will find some success. But always know you have your roots in this place and these people. We will always try to nourish and support you. Stretch your wings and fly. Find beauty and love and hope and life in this brave new world. For this is your destiny. And remember, wherever and however you find yourselves, you are always rooted in the love and support of God. Amen.
We often think of the word disciple as meaning follower, as in the disciples of Jesus. But in fact, the word disciple means learner. We give thanks for the way our church supports learning through programs like Sunday school and Bible study, through the opportunities it gives people of all ages to put their beliefs into action. As we continue to share in God's mission to adapt and be responsive to the needs around us in this unusual time, we acknowledge the financial gifts that you give and continue to give to support the ministry of our church and the wider church.
Thank you.
before we join in the prayer, just want to say thank you to all the gifts that have been offered, the speeches in the from the graduates, the music that was offered in reflection by Jessica, by Rhonda, by Carla, by Francis. We are a talent-filled people, and it is significant that we offer those gifts to one another. Let us pray. We could possibly be the healing for those who suffer. We could possibly be the strength for those who long to endure. We could possibly be the hope for those buffeted by the world. And so today, we offer ourselves as well as our gifts in the hopes that you will bless others who are in your heart. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now we welcome Liz Basisti, who with Tanya Pritchard are going to be offering us the prayers of concern and intercession for our congregation.
As we gather in reflection and silence, we are thankful for our beautiful Kelowna Valley and Okanagan Lake, all the plants and animals that we are fortunate to have among us, for our family and our friends. We pray with our hearts and minds filled with concern for our community leaders, city, provincial, federal, and world governments. God help them to use their powers well. We pray for our minds that we may find peace amid the chaos that surrounds us. We pray with concern for all the people who have the coronavirus. We pray for their return to good health. We pray for and are thankful for the doctors, nurses, and care aides, first responders, and others. We pray for their safety and good health. We pray for each of you who have remained cheerful and compliant over these past few months of isolation. Thank you. We pray for other ministers, churches, and their congregations in our area. We pray for our brothers and sisters traumatized by racial crisis, abuse, and bullying. We pray for us, privileged whites. Help us to understand and overcome our shame. We pray for our friends in El Triunfo, El Salvador. We pray for the homeless and marginalized in our community, for those feeling frustrated and rejected. We thank you for the gifts of our graduates, their excitement, their wonder, their curiosity, their leadership and contributions that have blessed and challenged us and made us a richer, more diverse community. As they step forward into the world that awaits, help them face their fears and uncertainties with the knowledge that you are with them. Guide their feet as they move through life. Strengthen them to continue to walk in the footsteps of Jesus as modern-day disciples in a world that needs their spirit. We thank you for those who taught and worked beside them and those who supported them along the way. We pray for your blessing upon Greta Friesen, Colin Hillman, Lindsay Meyer, Fraser Newberry, Graham Phillips, John Gaba, Alexander James, and Corrine McLeod. We pray that with your love, we may all be reconciled. Tanya Pritchard will now share this week's congregational prayer list.
We would also like to pray for Janet Smith, Margaret Scott, Bill Adamson. Beloved Susan Seal. Lauren Aston. Pamela Broadhurst. And Barbara Sparrow. This week, we additionally pray for Chris Rockner. And now we join in the words that Jesus taught his disciples to pray, singing.
Now, as we prepare to move from this time of worship to the breakout rooms and the talk and the conversation and the love and the fellowship that builds and supports this community, we're going to prepare ourselves to go with a hymn of blessing from Voices United, number 481.
May God, who creates, sustains, and redeems all life, continue to bless you and bring you peace. Go in peace.
Wonderful. I just didn't know there were so many Nickies in our world. This is so wonderful. We are about to head out into the breakout rooms, and I am delighted to know that that's going to be happening. One of the things that, of course, will have to happen is that we